Anderson Cooper, AC 360, CNN weeknights 10 Eastern.
Well, charges and countercharges in the race to be California's next governor. The charges are the Republican candidate Meg Whitman employed an illegal immigrant as a housekeeper. Now, Ms. Whitman says the controversy is being orchestrated by the campaign of her opponent, Jerry Brown. Today, the former housekeeper spoke along with her attorney, Gloria Allred, who unveiled what she said was a smoking gun letter from the federal government questioning the housekeeper's status.
Until she decided to run for governor in 2009, it appears that Ms. Whitman had no problem or concern about employing an undocumented worker. Apparently, she knew that employing an undocumented worker while running for a high-profile public office was a potential liability.
I was shocked and hurt that Ms. Whitman would treat me this way after 9 years. I realized at that moment that she didn't appreciate my work. I felt like she was throwing me away like a piece of garbage.
Well, that's the backdrop. Tom Foreman has been fact-checking both sides' claims. Tom?
Well, you know, Anderson, celebrity attorney Gloria Allred clearly intended to drop a bombshell on Republican gubernatorial candidate Meg Whitman with all of this. Her claim, as you said, is that Whitman knowingly employed an illegal immigrant named Nikki Diaz-Santillon, exploited her, denied her wages, and finally fired her and kept voters in the dark about all of this. Whitman says no. Listen.
Attempt to deceive the public and hide the fact that she knew that she was employing an undocumented worker long before she fired Nikki in 2009 has failed. Meg Whitman is exposed as a liar and a hypocrite.
Make no mistake, these allegations are completely untrue. They lack any merit whatsoever. This is truly a political smear on me, on my family, and based on lies.
Tom, what's the truth here?
Well, we know that Nikki Santillon was Whitman's housekeeper. We know that she provided Whitman with Social Security card, a driver's license, and an official federal form that Ms. Santillon appears to have signed herself, swearing that she's here legally. Look at this, Anderson. She even put a little smiley face right down here on the whole thing. So the simple truth is that the immigration officials say, by law, that's all that Whitman had to check out. She didn't have to follow up on any of that. It appears Social Security sent a letter to Ms. Whitman also and her husband saying there might have been a problem with Ms. Santillon's Social Security number. Ms. Allred says that letter is proof that they were, in effect, told that she was here illegally. But immigration and Social Security officials said, no, lots of these letters go out for lots of reasons. It's not even necessarily a red flag. That's what they told me when I called today. And the candidate has said when she found out about the illegal status, she did fire Ms. Santillon, which under law she would have to do. And she's even said she'll take a lie detector test about all of this, Anderson.
So let's look at the other side of the coin here. Well, I mean, what don't we know?
Well, what we don't know is these accusations that Ms. Whitman somehow misused Ms. Santillon. We have no real proof of that. Ms. Whitman's claim that her opponent, Jerry Brown, orchestrated this attack, we have no proof of that either, although Ms. Allred is an avid supporter of Mr. Brown. She said she's had no contact with his campaign in all of this.
Also, Gloria Allred has launched a similar claim late in a political race before, didn't she?
Yeah, just before Republican Arnold Schwarzenegger won the governor's office, Ms. Allred went to the media with a woman who claimed that he fondled her and took lewd pictures of her on a movie set. In short, that case came to nothing. But listen to how Ms. Allred reacted when pressed about that on an L.A. radio show this week, Anderson.
You did this to Arnold in August of 2003 for Rhonda Miller. Did Rhonda ever win a judgment against Arnold, making allegations against a gubernatorial candidate?
Yeah, I made allegations, yes, that's true.
Did Rhonda win a judgment?
Rhonda did not proceed with her case through litigation.
Is that a no?
Well, she decided not to go. The case was litigated, and the case basically ended up being dismissed. She decided not to appeal.
It was dismissed.
Wait a minute. She decided not to appeal from the dismissal, which she had every right to do.
We cut that down to give you just the essence of it. But while she kept saying that she wants to get the facts out in this new case, she showed no real interest in being cross-examined on them. In fact, in the end, She hung up on Hugh Hewitt, the talk show host there. So, Anderson, on our scale, the claims against Ms. Whitman in this case appear to be a very tall tale.